Everyone, please remain standing for a minute of silent prayers. Thank you. Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, I move for a few minutes suspension.
Without objection, session suspended.
Thank you.
Session resume. Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, I move that we defer the calling of the roll.
Without objection, motion is granted. Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, I move that we approve journals number 49, 50, and 51 dated Feb 1, Feb 2, and Feb 3, 2016.
Without objection, motion is granted.
Mr. Speaker, I move that we defer the reference of business.
Without objection, motion is granted.
Mr. Speaker, I move that we defer. Mr. Speaker, I move that we are in receipt of the bicameral conference committee report on the disagreeing provisions of House Bill number 6040 and Senate Bill number 2419, which seeks to ban the reappointment of a regular member of the Judicial Bar Council who has already served a full term. Mr. Speaker, in accordance with our rules, I move that we ratify the said bicameral conference committee report.
There's a motion to ratify the bicameral conference committee report on the House bills and Senate bills aforementioned. Is there any objection? The chair hears none. The motion is granted. Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, we are on receipt of the bicameral conference committee report on the disagreeing provisions of House Bill number 4116 and Senate Bill number 2947, which seeks to strengthen the balanced housing development program. Mr. Speaker, in accordance with our rules, I move that we ratify the said bicameral conference committee report.
There's a motion to ratify the bicameral conference committee report on the disagreeing provision of House Bill number 4116 and Senate Bill number 2947. Are there any objections? The chair is none. The motion is granted. Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, we are in receipt of the bicameral conference committee report of the disagreeing provisions of House Bill number 5855 and Senate Bill number 2950, which seeks to reorganize and modernize the National Bureau of Investigation. In accordance with the rules, I move that we ratify the said bicameral conference committee report.
There's a motion to ratify the bicameral conference committee report on the disagreeing provisions of House Bill number 5855 and Senate Bill number 2950. Are there any objections? The chair is none. The motion is granted. Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, we are in receipt of the bicameral conference committee report on disagreeing provisions of House Bill number 5911 and Senate Bill number 2999 mandating the installation of speed limiters in public utility vehicles. In accordance with the rules, I move to ratify the said bicameral conference committee report.
There's a motion to ratify the bicameral conference committee report on the disagreeing provisions of House Bill number 5911 and Senate Bill number 2999. Are there any objection? The chair is none. The motion is granted.
Mr. Speaker, we had a receipt of the Bicameral Conference Committee report on the disagreeing provisions of House Bill number 6395 and Senate Bill number 3023, which seeks to amend investment restrictions and specific laws governing adjustment companies, lending companies, financing companies, and investment houses cited in the foreign investment negative list. In accordance with the rules, I move that we ratify the said Bicameral Conference Committee report.
There's a motion to ratify the Bicameral Conference Committee report on the disagreeing provisions of House Bill number 6395 and Senate Bill number 3023. Are there any objection? The chair is none. The motion is granted. Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, we had receipt of a message from the Senate informing the House that the Senate passed with amendments House Bill number 772, which seeks to exempt surviving children of military personnel who are mentally incapacitated from termination of benefits upon reaching the age of 21. We have been advised that the Committee on National Defense and Security, sponsor of House Bill number 772, as well as the authors thereof, have no objections to the amendments introduced thereto by the Senate. In accordance with the rules, I move that we concur with the Senate amendments to House Bill number 772.
Are there any objections? The chair is none. The motion is granted. Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, we had received a message from the Senate informing the House that the Senate passed with amendments House Bill number 3785, which seeks to institutionalize direct credit support of the Land Bank of the Philippines to agrarian reform beneficiaries, small farmers, and fisherfolk. We have been advised that the Committee on Agrarian Reform, sponsor of the House Bill number 3785, as well as the author thereof, have no objections to the amendments introduced thereto by the Senate. In accordance with the rules, I move that we concur with Senate amendments to House Bill number 3785.
Are there any objections? The chair hears none. The motion is granted. Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, we had received a message from the Senate informing the House that the Senate passed with amendments House Bill number 5417, which seeks to regulate the Philippine credit card industry. We have been advised that the Committee on Banks and Financial Intermediaries, sponsor of House Bill number 5417, as well as the authors thereof, have no objections to the amendments introduced thereto by the Senate. In accordance with the rules, I move that we concur with the Senate amendments to House Bill number 5417.
Are there any objections? The chair is none. The motion is granted. Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, we are in receipt of messages from the Senate informing the House that the Senate passed with amendments various House bills seeking to establish national high schools in certain localities, namely House Bill number 3219, 3220, 3222, 3223, 5406, and 5446. We have been advised that the Committee on Basic Education and Culture, sponsor of the said bills, as well as the authors thereof, have no objections to the Senate amendments introduced thereto by the Senate. In accordance with the rules, I move for an omnibus motion to concur with the Senate amendments to House Bill number 3219, 3220, 3222, 3223, 5406, and 5446.
Are there any objections? The chair is none. Motion is granted. Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, we are in receipt of messages from the Senate informing the House that the Senate passed with amendments various House bills seeking to renew or extend franchises granted by Congress to certain companies, namely House Bill number 557155835584460126 and 6038. We have been advised that the Committee on Legislative Franchises, sponsor of the said House bills, as well as the authors thereof, have no objection to the amendments thereto by the Senate. In accordance with the rules, I move for an omnibus motion to concur with the Senate amendments to House Bill numbers 557155835844601 and 6038.
Are there any objections? The chair is none. The motion is granted. Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, the House and the Senate have approved on third reading House Bill number 6204 and Senate Bill number 3203, respectively, which seek to require basic education students to undergo cardiopulmonary resuscitation training. We have been informed that the Committee on Basic Education and Culture, sponsor of the Bill 6204, as well as the authors thereof, are in concurrence with the provisions of Senate Bill number 3204. Mr. Speaker, in accordance with the rules, I move that we adopt Senate Bill number 3204 as an amendment to House Bill number 6204.
Are there any objections? The chair is none. The motion is granted. Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, I move for a few minutes suspension.
Session suspended. Thank you. 10 minutes.
Thank you.
Session resume. Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, I move that we call the roll.
The Secretary General is directed to call the roll of members.
Roll call of members. Honorable Representatives. Abad. Abaya. Abillanosa. Abu. Abueg. Asidillo. On. Akop. Acosta Alba. Kong. At Bingkula. Agraw. Agabaw. Aglipay Bilyar. Agyaw. Albano. Alcala. Aliano. Aliping. Almario. Almonte. Alvarez Franz. Alvarez Mercedes. Amante. Amatong Isagani. Amatong Romel. Andaya. Angara Castillo. Angping. Antonino. Antonio. Apostol. Aragones. Arbison. Arenas. Arnaiz. Arroyo. Asilo. Atienza. Aumentado. Bagaw. Bagaching. Bagilat. Balindong. Banal. Barcelona Reyes. Barsaga. Batawil. Batocabe. Bautista. Bello. Belmonte Feliciano. Belmonte Jose Christopher. Belmonte Vicente. Benitez. Bernos. Biason. Bichara. Binay. Biron. Bondok. Bonoan. Bravo, Anthony. Bravo, Marebida. Briones. Bulut Bigtang. Kabilaw. Gagas. Kalalay. Calix Rubiano. Caminero. Cari. Castelo. Castro. Catamco. Cayetano. Celeste. Seravica. Cerillas. Chipeco. Co. Cuanco. Culiantes. Colmenares. Cortuna. Cosalan. Cruz González. Cuba. Cueva. Dalog. Dayangirang. Dasa. Desus. De Venecia. Defensor. Del Mar. Del Rosario Anthony. Del Rosario Antonio. De La Cruz. De Los Montalia. Dimaporo Abdullah. Dimaporo Imelda. Duavit. Durano. D. Echeverri. Enverga. Erice. Erigel. Ermita Buain. Escudero. Espina. Estrella. Ebardone. Pariñas. Fernando. Fernandez. Ferrer Jeffrey. Ferrer Luis. Ferriol. Flores. Fortun. Fortuno. Fentebella. Gray. Garcia Rique. Garcia Gwendolyn. Garcia Albano. Garin Richard. Garin Sharon. Gachelian Sherwin. Gachelian Wes. Heron.
Gerona Robedo. Goana Cristina. Gornulfo. Gomez. Gonzalez Neptali. Gonzalez Fernando. Goriseta. Guanlao. Giao. Gulias. Gunigundo. Gutierrez. Hagedorn. Haresco. Ataman Saliman. Hernandez. Hiccup. Hofer. Ilagan. Iway. Olesos. Javier. Cato. Co. Comun. Labad-labad. Lacson Noel. Lagdamay Antonio. Lagdamay Amerik Yasmin. Lagman. Lanete. Lechon. Ledesma. Lee. Leonardia. Leone Pizarro. Lobrigat. Long. Lopez Carlo. Lopez Carlo Jane. Loyola. Macapagalaroyo. Macroho Nuno. Madrona. Magsaysay. Manalo. Mangodadato. Marcos. Mascarinha. Musongsong. Matugas. Miliana. Mendoza Osilito. Mendoza Mark Leandro. Mendoza Raymond. Mercado. Mercado Revilla. Mirasol. Monteo. Nava JC Raman. Nava Pablo. Noel. Nograles. Uaminal. Ocampo. Olivares. Ong. Ortega Francisco. Ortega Victor. Pacquiao. Padilla. Paduano. Paes. Pagdilaw. Pancho. Panganiban. Pakis. Pernes. Piemonte. Plaza. Poncerile. Tunisia Sagabas. Puno. Kimbo. Kisumbing. Rodasa. Ramirez Sato. Ramos. Relampagos. Revilla. Ridon. Rivera. Robes. Rodriguez Isidro. Rodriguez Maximo. Rodriguez Oscar. Rodriguez Rufus. Roman. Romarate. Romualdez. Romualdo. Romulo. Roque. Sakdalan. Sahali. Sakaluran. Salimbangon. Salvacion. Santiago. Sarmientos. Sema. Singson Eric. Singson Ronald. Swan Singh. Suarez. Si Alvarado. Tambunting. Tan Angelina. Tan Milagrosa. Tejada. Chedoro. Tevez. Chanco. Cheng. Ting. Tiño. Tolentino. Treñas. Tugna. Tupas. Turabin Ataman. T. T. Delgado. Umali Charina. Umali Reynaldo. Unabia. Ungab. Uy Juliet. Uy Rolando. Vargas. Vargas Alfonso. Vilarde. Velasco Lloyd Allen. Velasco Lorna. Villanueva. Villar. Villarica. Villago. Yap Arthur. Yap Susan. You. Samora Maracanen. Samora Ronaldo. Sarate. Subiri. The spirit is present. Mr. Speaker, the roll call shows that 189 members responded to the call.
With 189 members responding to the call, the chair declares the existence of quorum.
Mr. Speaker, I wish to rise on a matter of personal and collective privilege, Mr. Speaker.
Mr. Speaker, I move for a few minutes suspension.
Suspended.
Thank you.
Session resume. Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, I move that we recognize the Honorable Colmenares for his privileged speech.
The gentleman from Bayan Muna, the Honorable Colmenares, is recognized to deliver a personal and collective privilege.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I wish to rise on a matter of personal and collective privilege, Mr. Speaker. Ang Kongresong ito, matapos ng mahabang at maraming hearings, mula pa noong 2011, nag-approve ng isang batas na dagdagan ng 2,000 piso ang SSS pension. Inapprove ng House at inapprove ng Senado only to be rebuffed by President Aquino on January 12 of 2016 with a veto transmitted to this House. Mr. Speaker, hindi totoo na mababankrupt ang SSS, which was the justification made in the veto message of President Aquino. Ang problema lang sa SSS, Mr. Speaker, ang resort nila para dagdagan ang pension is immediately go into increase in contribution. Very reasonable ang House. Ano ang sabi ng House at ng Senado? Bakit first resort nyo ang pag-increase ng kontribusyon? Bakit hindi muna tayo, Mr. Speaker, i-source natin ang pondo para sa 2,000 increase by one, taasan nyo ang collection rate efficiency nyo. 38% collection rate efficiency, may collectible kayo na 325 billion pesos kahit kalahati lang ng 325 billion pesos ang makolekta nyo, sapat na yan para sa 2,000 increase. Another source of fund, ang sabi ng Kongresong ito, efficiency rin sa inyong operation. Napakalaki ng sweldo ang operating cost ng SSS. In fact, we are the highest in Asia, from 9 to 12% ng pondo ng miyembro ginagastos ng SSS sa sweldo at iba pang mga perks nila. Pangatlo, ayusin nyo ang inyong investment, Mr. Speaker. That is another source of fund. Kaya very clear ang Kongreso at sabi ng Kongreso, if after 3 taon ng reforma nyo, hindi pa rin nyo kaya yung 2,000 increase, then government should subsidize. Is that found in the law, Mr. Speaker? Yes. The law section 20 of Republic Act 8282 says that the government should subsidize SSS kung kailangan dagdagan ng pensyon. Mula nang tinayo ang SSS noong 1987, ang gobyerno ng Pilipinas kahit 5, Mr. Speaker, did not allocate to the SSS pension fund. Ang ibang bansa, like Vietnam, like Thailand, subsidized ang pension nila. In fact, in Thailand, 3% ang employer, 3% ang employee, 1% ang gobyerno sa kontribusyon. So, Mr. Speaker, ginagawa yan ng ibang bansa dahil ang pagtaas ng pensyon, Mr. Speaker, is not only tulong doon sa ating mga senior citizens, kundi tulong din sa lokal na ekonomiya. Dahil gagastusin yun ng ating mga senior citizens sa lokal na ekonomiya. Pangalawa, ang pagdagdag pensyon, Mr. Speaker, tulong din yan para ma-ease ang burden sa health system. Kasi pag ang senior citizens natin hindi makabili ng gamot, hindi makakain ng tamang pagkain, magkakasakit, kargo yan ng local government unit health system. Kaya ang ibang bansa, sinasubsidize ang increase in pension. Dito nag-agree ang Senate at ang Hayon sa SSS, Mr. Speaker, and this can be borne out sa transcript ng Senate hearing. They will only need 4 billion pesos, Mr. Speaker, para i-fund yung 2,000 peso increase. Chicken feed, Mr. Speaker, ang 4 na bilyon sa isang 3 trilyon na budget. We have for our expenses dyan sa budget for 2016, 4.8 billion pesos para pambayad sa kuryente ng Texas Instruments. at pambayad sa kuryente ng Hanjin Corporation, why don't we have 4 billion for SSS pensioners? Ang SSS po, every 4 years, naglalabas yan ng isang study kung kailan sila mababankrupt. Ganun talaga yan. Lahat ng insurance companies, lahat ng SSS sa buong mundo, naglalabas ng study kung kailan sila mababankrupt. Ang problema dito sa SSS, tinakot nila si President Aquino, natakot naman si President Aquino. Noong 2000 year, Mr. Speaker, ayon mismo sa SSS, mababankrupt sila in 15 years mula 2000. Mababankrupt na sila in 2015, last year. Noong 2003, naglabas sila, Mr. Speaker, ng another study. Pwede na pala silang mabankrupt sa 2031 na, hindi na 2015. Noong 2007 or 4 years later, naglabas sila ng study, 2039 na ang bankruptcy nila. Ngayon, noong 2011, Mr. Speaker, naglabas sila ng study na ang bankruptcy period pala nila is 2049. Kaya, Mr. Speaker, yan naman ay study lang, pero yan ang hangganan ng pondo mo kung wala kang gagawin. Pero walang SSS na nababankrupt sa buong mundo, Mr. Speaker, precisely because actuarial studies are merely studies kung hanggang saan ang pondo mo kung wala kang gagawin. Ang ino-offer ng Kongreso as sources of funds, yung sinabi niyang reforms kanina plus subsidy. Kaya, Mr. Speaker, napaka-valid and justifiable ng pag-approve ng Kongresong ito ng bill na magdadagdag ng 2,000 piso sa SSS pension. Ngayon, Mr. Speaker, nakaamba yung pag-override sa veto ni President Aquino. Bakit kailangan nating i-override? Dahil ito ang tama. Ito ang kailangan ng ating mga senior citizens, Mr. Speaker. Dapat ipakita nating mga congressman at congresswomen ng 16th Congress na ang issue ng SSS hindi pang-eleksyon. Na ngayon, Mayo 23 na, ipaglaban pa rin natin ang 2,000 pisong dagdag SSS pension dahil ito ang tama, Mr. Speaker, at ito ang kailangan ng ating mga senior citizens. We in the 16th Congress, whatever our political fortunes were in the last election, should come here today and leave behind a lasting legacy, lalo na sa mga katulad kong natalo sa election. Bago man lang kami lumisan sa Kongresong ito, mag-iiwan kami ng isang lasting legacy para maalaala forevermore ng ating mga senior citizens ang 2,000 pisong dagdag sa SSS pension. Pero, Mr. Speaker, para ma-achieve natin ito, kailangan natin umattend ang lahat ng miyembro ng Kongreso na bumoto para dito. Kailangan po natin ng at least 193 kaboto, Mr. Speaker. Kung hindi magkaroon ng quorum dito sa House ng 193 or more, hindi po natin mafafile ang motion to override, Mr. Speaker. Bakit? Kasi hindi natin aabutin ang 192. Kaya, Mr. Speaker, the issue of SSS goes into the essence of the House of Representatives, its prestige, its dignity, and its honor, Mr. Speaker. Natindigan natin ang ating pinasa na batas at ipaglaban natin hanggang sa kahuli-hulihan. Would be very thankful to the House leadership kung pagbigyan itong ating panukala na i-override ang motion. Ang panawagan sa lahat ng miyembro, kailangan po nating dumalo sa susunod po na mga panahon para magkaroon tayo ng sufficient number sa quorum para magkaroon ng boto to override the veto of President Aquino. This is our legacy, and we ask the leadership and the members of the 16th Congress for the last time before we disband this Congress, let us make history. And we file the motion and vote to override the veto of President Aquino para maipatupad pa rin ang 2,000 pisong dagdag sa SSS pension. Maraming maraming salamat, Mr. Speaker, and I hope our colleagues will give me this recognition, and with the indulgence of our members, allow me to file that motion to override when the proper time comes, Mr. Speaker. Maraming salamat, magandang hapon, at maraming salamat din sa lahat ng miyembro ng Kongreso na nagpakita sa akin ng suporta at respeto sa tatlong termino ko sa Kongreso. Maraming salamat po.
Maraming salamat, Ginoong Colmenares. Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker.
Mr. Speaker, I move that we take up reference of business and that the Secretary General be directed to read all titles of bills.
Without objection, the motion is granted.
Mr. Speaker.
Secretary General is directed to
Mr.
read.
Mr. Speaker.
There's already a motion granted. We'll have
Mr.
to
Speaker.
Take it.
I was raising my hand. You did not even give me a chance to be recognized.
The motion,
po ang ating Kongreso, ganito pa rin natin papatakbo.
We will recognize you after the reference of business paid, Your Honor.
Well, I take note of this, Mr. Speaker. I'd like to manifest. Lahat ng ginagawa natin for the past 3 years, wala sa tamang alituntunin. And I reiterate my position that we are not doing properly. And I would like to support the position of the Honorable Colmenares. Kumuha naman tayo ng paraan para ang ating Kongreso
okay.
Sa ating paghihiwalay.
Thank you. Thank you, gentlemen.
Sa paghihiwalay nitong Kongreso ito, may gawin tayong tama. Okay. Maraming salamat po.
Thank you. The Secretary General is directed to read the bills and resolutions on first reading for referral to the appropriate committees.
Reference of Business Bills on First Reading, House Bill 6444, granting Philippine citizenship to Arian Luis B. Calingo, Representative Castelo.
Committee on Rule, or Committee on Justice, rather.
House Bill number 6448, naming the Lawag Bypass Road as Rodolfo G. Pariñas Jr. Road, of Kimbo.
To the Committee on Public Works and Highways.
House Bill number 6450, prohibiting the planting of plants and trees and the construction of any structure other or within the right-of-way clearance of all power transmission lines, Representative Umali, Masongsong, Rodriguez, and Caminero.
To the Committee on Energy.
House Bill 6457, requiring mandatory security inspection in shopping malls and other security places of Vargas.
To the Committee on Public Order and Safety.
House Bill number 6458, expanding the composition of local school boards of Vargas.
To the Committee on Local Government.
House Bill number 6463, prohibiting a person from knowingly permitting a motor vehicle owned or controlled by him to be driven by a person who is not authorized of Vargas.
To the Committee on Transportation.
House Bill 6464, establishing a national scholarship program for studies in nuclear science of Vargas.
To the Committee on Science and Technology.
House Bill 6476, establishing a pregnancy support service under office under the Oasis of Vargas.
To the Committee on Health.
House Bill 6477, requiring health insurance companies of Vargas.
To the Committee on Health.
House Bill 6481, mandating the use of safe cleaning products of Vargas.
To the Committee on Health.
House Bill 6482, requiring basic education students to undergo CPR training of Vargas.
To the Committee on Basic Education and Culture.
House Bill 6487, providing for the construction of multi-purpose gym in all municipalities and cities of Vargas.
To the Committee on Public Works and Highways.
Additional reference of business resolution, House Concurrent Resolution Number 15, concurrent resolution providing for the House of Representatives and the Senate to hold a joint public session to canvass the votes cast for President, Vice President in the national elections held on May 9, 2016 and proclaim the President-elect and Vice-President-elect Representatives Belmonte, Gonzalez, and Zamora.
To the Committee on Rules.
House Bill number 6488, granting public elementary school students pre-admission to all public museums at Vargas.
To the Committee on Basic Education and Culture.
House Bill 6469, institutionalizing the opening of night classes at Vargas.
To the Committee on Basic Education and Culture.
House Bill 6493, providing for minimum monthly net take-home pay for all government employees at Vargas.
To the Committee on Appropriations.
House Bill 6499, Establishing Environmental Awareness of Leonardia.
To the Committee on Basic Education and Culture.
House Bill 6500, Amending Article 202 of Act Number 3815 as amended, said Leonardia.
To the Committee on Revision of Law.
House Bill 6504, Establishing an Enhanced Program to Counter Absenteeism, said Leonardia.
To the Committee on Basic Education and Culture.
House Bill 6505, Establishing Special Lanes and Providing Mechanism in Crossing the Street for PWD, Senior Citizens and Pregnant Women, Representative Leonardia.
To the Committee on Social Services.
House Bill 6510, Mandating the Installation of High-Speed Wireless Broadband Connections, Sir Villanosa.
To the Committee on Information and Communications Technology.
House Bill 6511, Mandating the Donation of All Surplus or Leftover but Still Edible Foods, Sir Delgado.
To the Committee on Trade and Industry.
Resolutions, House Solution 2657, expressing the profound condolences of the House of the family of Honorable Hilario L. De Pedro III, Sir Belmonte Gonzalez and Zamora.
To the Committee on Rules.
Committee reports. Report numbers 1022, 1023, 1026 on House Bill number 6442, 6443, 6447.
To the Committee on Rules.
Report number 1044 by the Special Committee on Saturday Tagalog Development, House Bill number 6475.
To the Committee on Rules. Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, I move that we consider House Concurrent Resolution number 15 and direct the Secretary General to read title of said House Concurrent Resolution.
Without objection, the motion is granted. The Secretary General is directed to read the title of House Concurrent Resolution number 015.
Mr. Speaker. Mr.
House Speaker. Concurrent Resolution number 15. Concurrent Resolution providing for the House of Representatives and the Senate to hold a joint public session to canvass the vote cast for President and Vice President in the national elections held on May 9, 2016 and proclaim the President-elect and Vice President-elect.
Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, I move that we adopt House Concurrent Resolution number 15.
There's a motion to adopt House Concurrent Resolution number 15. Are there any objection? The chair is none. The said resolution is adopted. Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker.
The gentleman
Mr.
from,
Speaker, the Honorable Lito Atienza wishes to be recognized.
The gentleman Speaker. From Manila, the Honorable Chancellor is recognized.
Thank you. The gentleman from Bayan Muna pointed out a very, very critical issue which we did not allow to be ventilated further. Para bagang itinabilamang natin ang napakahalagang mensahe ni Congressman Colmenares. Ngayon po, mga tinetake up natin, mga resolusyon, mga amendment, whatever it is that are now listed in our business for the day. Can't we go back and take up a very important issue taken up by Congressman Colmenares para po naman tayo makagawa ng tamang aksyon? If we are not going to take up this important issue, then there is no reason for this continuation of this session. I am questioning the quorum, Mr. Speaker. I don't think we have enough numbers anymore.
Mr. Speaker, I move to adjourn. Suspend session for a few minutes.
I move to adjourn.
Session suspended.
If there is no quorum. I move that we call the roll again, Mr. Speaker, to establish a quorum. Otherwise, we all go home.
Announcement. Announcement, please. The honorable members of the House of Representatives are reminded that the joint session for the canvassing of the votes cast for President and Vice President in the national elections held on May 9, 2016 will be at 2 p.m. tomorrow afternoon. Repeating announcement, the honorable members of the House are reminded that the joint public session to canvass the votes cast for President and Vice President in the national elections held on May 9, 2016 will be at 2 p.m. tomorrow afternoon. Thank you.
Thank you. change it. Sir? Mag-adjourn ba tayo kasi kung wala nang paano kung walang quorum. Pwede sir. Pwede. Feeling ko sir, pwede bang suspend na lang? June 10 sir is a Friday. Mag-suspend lang tayo sir. Suspend lang sir. Oh, that's the safest sir.
Until 4 o'clock.
Nang joint session sir. Pero hindi sa regular session natin.
Joke pa no, session suspended 2 o'clock tomorrow.
Give way to the joint session. Give way to the joint session. Kawawa naman yung mag-o-out sir. Oh, nakabihis pa naman. Kahit man lang mag-o-out man lang. X-Men sir. O wala pa yung Civil War sir. Tapos may plot. Tapos yung ano yun, sir, yung legislative performance record. May audio-video pa yun. Ewan ko kung ano yung bonus ni sir. Hindi, di akin ko yun. Di akin. Usually sa last day yun, sir. Mukhang goodbye na tayo. Kawawa naman. Pa pwedeng pag-o-taking na lang siya sa harapan ng speaker. Anong ina-repro mo? Hindi pa nagkaigi? Sa order niya, pupunin natin yung balota. Yung ngayon yung kakanda.
ni sir siguro mag-adjourn na. Wednesday mag-action plan ba siya?
Open, open na. Open na.
Pero mahirap yung baka din yan.
Kasi China eh. Kasi China eh.
Panalo naman sir.
Vice President.
O nga pala. Tapos boss, pinutest na naman.
Congratulations again, ma'am. Nakita mo yung picture nyo. Ay, ma'am. Bakit na kayo, ma'am? Ma'am, joint session na tayo bukas ng hapon.
Ayaw na po ba?
From 2 p.m. ma'am.
Kasi wala ka na naman tao. Wala na naman tao. Motion to adjourn yun. Motion to adjourn.
Kala ko roll call yung ginawa
yun. Motion to adjourn siya.
Session is resumed. Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker.
The gentleman from Manila, the Honorable Achanza, is recognized.
We are reiterating our concern on the issue of our overriding bill on the veto of President Aquino of the very important benefit that our senior citizens are waiting for. We passed through a very rigorous campaign. The question that has been asked all over the country is that question. Is Congress overriding the veto of President Aquino? And we have to assure them that we will try our very best to do our share. Kanina po, binanggit ni Congressman Calmenares ang kahalagahan nitong measure na ito at yung hindi makatarungan ang ginawa ng ating pagiging dating Pangulo. So at this point in time, all we would ask the chair and the majority leader and the majority of this chamber, kung di man natin titake up into ngayon, kailan po ba natin pwedeng schedule para po naman magkaroon ng seguridad at tiwala ang ating mga mamamayan na umaasa rito sa ating Kongreso, nagagawa tayo ng hakbang upang ituwid ang nakikita nating pagkakamali ng namumuno ngayon. So I reiterate my question, Mr. Speaker,
and
I'm directing it to the Majority Floor Leader.
The Majority Leader is directed to respond.
My recollection, Mr. Speaker, in so far as the privileged speech of the distinguished gentleman from Bayan Muna, the Honorable Colmenares, a while ago, was that while it is his desire to move for a override of the veto of the president of the SSS additional benefits law. But he himself said that he is not at this point in time willing to do so, as it will require a number of 193 votes, in fact, Mr. Speaker. And that is the reason why that the Honorable Colmenares mentioned a while ago that at the proper time, should there be enough members to constitute a number workable to have an override of the veto of the president, then he will make that appropriate motion. Much as I want to directly answer the time frame demanded by the distinguished gentleman from Buhay, I cannot really say when would that appropriate time would be, because as I've said, even the distinguished gentleman from Bayan Muna, the Honorable Colmenares, realizing that the requirement of the Constitution is 2/3 vote of all the members of the House, then he himself made that reservation to do so at the proper time.
Mr. Speaker, we'd like to thank the Majority Floor Leader for his further explaining the position of the majority on this issue. Let me rephrase my question and rearrange it then, accepting the fact that we need to have a certain number to be able to override a presidential veto. Can we get his assurance then, as the Majority Floor Leader of this outgoing Congress, that as soon as we get a majority number that we need to override the presidential veto, the majority leader will join us in our efforts to immediately act on this very important issue? Pwede po ba naming makuha sa kanya yung kanyang garantiya? Take a pill lang po natin, pagbutohan natin. Kung hindi po bumoto ng pabor yung nakararaming nandito, tatanggapin po natin yun sapagkat yun ang sinasaad ng batas. Pero kailangan po natin take a pin, at ang hinihingi ko lang ngayon, yung garantiyang titake a pin natin if we can muster a quorum tomorrow, Wednesday, Thursday, we will take up the issue. May we be assured of this action of the Majority Floor Leader, knowing his full control and influence on the majority of this present Congress.
Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, it is always the submission of this representation that we will we respect the position of any member to file the appropriate motion in this chamber. And surely we will not be a hindrance to any move for such a motion should the proper time arise, Mr. Speaker.
With that, Mr. Speaker, I'm taking it as an assurance that the measure will be taken up if we can muster the number in tomorrow, Wednesday, or Thursday session. And we will not experience a sudden adjournment of session nor an avoidance of the issue. Yun po naman ang aming hinihintay at hinihintay ng buong bansa dito sa Kongresong papalabas na.
Thank you.
Salamat.
I think we have resolved the issue. Thank you. Majority Leader, let's proceed.
Mr. Speaker, the House and the Senate have approved on third reading House Bill number 4832 and Senate Bill number 3205. We have been informed that the Committee on Higher and Technical Education, sponsor of the House Bill number 4832, as well as the authors thereof, are in concurrence with the provision of Senate Bill number 3205. In accordance with our rules, I move that we adopt the Senate Bill number 3205 as an amendment to House Bill number 4832. So move, Mr. Speaker.
There's a motion to adopt Senate Bill number 3205 as an amendment to House Bill number 4832. Is there any objection? The Chair hears none. The motion is granted. Majority Leader.
Likewise, Mr. Speaker, the Senate has approved on third reading House Bill number... The House and the Senate have approved on third reading House Bill number 5572 and Senate Bill number 3209. We have been informed that the Committee on Women and Gender Equality are in concurrence with the provisions of Senate Bill Number 3209. In accordance with our rules, I move that we adopt Senate Bill Number 3209 as an amendment to House Bill Number 5572. So moved, Mr. Speaker.
There's a motion to adopt Senate Bill Number 3209 as an amendment to House Bill Number 5572. Are there any objection? The chair is none. The motion is granted.
Mr. Speaker, we just want to... Can the distinguished majority leader please give us an idea what that particular amendment is all about? At least read the Senate version.
Okay, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, the House and the Senate have approved on third reading House Bill Number 4544 and Senate Bill Number 2794, respectively, providing for the new Anti-Carnapping Act of 2015. We have been informed that the Committee on Revision of Laws, sponsors of House Bill Number 4544, as well as the authors thereof, are in concurrence with the provisions of Senate Bill Number 2794. In accordance with our rules, I move that we adopt Senate Bill Number 2794 as an amendment to House Bill Number 4544.
There's a motion to adopt Senate Bill Number 2794 as an amendment to House Bill Number 4544. Are there any objection? The chair is none. The motion is granted.
The House, Mr. Speaker, the House and the Senate have approved on third reading House Bill Number 5780 and Senate Bill Number 449, respectively, honoring and granting additional benefits to Filipino centenarians. We have been informed that the Committee on Population and Family Relations, sponsor of House Committee, House Bill Number 5780, as well as the authors thereof, are in concurrence with the provisions of Senate Bill Number 449. Accordingly, I move that we adopt Senate Bill Number 449 as an amendment to House Bill Number 5780. So moved, Speaker.
There's a motion to adopt Senate Bill Number 449 as an amendment to House Bill Number 5780. Are there any objection? The chair is not. The motion is granted.
Likewise, Mr. Speaker, the House and the Senate have approved on third reading House Bill Number 4146 and Senate Bill Number 2422, respectively, increasing the prescriptive period from 50 years to 30 years for the violation of Republic Act 3019, otherwise known as the Anti-Graft and Corrupt Practices Act. I've been informed that the Committee on Revision of Laws, sponsor of House Bill Number 4146, as well as the authors thereof, are in concurrence with the provisions of Senate Bill Number 2422. Accordingly, Mr. Speaker, I move that we adopt Senate Bill Number 2422 as an amendment to House Bill Number 4146.
Are there any objection to the motion? The chair hears none. Motion is granted.
Likewise, Mr. Speaker, when receipt of message from the Senate informing the House that the Senate on May 23, 2016 passed with amendments House Bill Number 5511 entitled An Act Establishing the Southwestern Tagalog Region to be known as Mimaropa Region. We have been advised that the Special Committee on Southern Tagalog Development, sponsor of the said House Bill, as well as the authors thereof, have no objection to the amendments introduced by the Senate. In accordance with our rules, I move that we concur with the Senate amendment. So moved, Speaker.
Are there any objection? The chair hears none. The motion is granted.
Likewise, Speaker, we are in receipt of the message from the Senate informing the House that the Senate on May 23, 2016 passed with amendments House Bill Number 6152 entitled An Act Declaring the Province of Batanes as a Responsible Community-Based Cultural Heritage and Ecotourism Zone. We have been advised that the Committee on Tourism, sponsor of the said House Bill, as well as the authors thereof, concurs with the amendments introduced by the Senate. Accordingly, I move that we concur with the Senate amendments to House Bill Number 6152. So moved, Speaker.
Are there any objection to the motion? The chair is none. The motion is granted.
Likewise, Mr. Speaker, we are in receipt of message from the Senate informing the House that the Senate on May 23, 2016, passed with amendments House Bill Number 3145 entitled An Act Creating an Additional Regional Trial Court Branch to be stationed in Calapan City and an Additional Municipal Trial Court Branch to be stationed in Municipality of Baco. all in the first district of Oriental Mindoro. We have been advised that the Committee on Justice, sponsor of the said House bill, together with its authors, are in concurrence with the amendments introduced by the Senate. Accordingly, I move that we concur with the Senate amendments to House Bill number 2145.
Any objection to the motion made? The Chair hears none. The motion is granted.
The House and the Senate have approved on third reading House Bill number 925 and Senate Bill number 2239, respectively, requiring all franchise holders or operators of television stations and producers of television programs to broadcast or present their programs with closed captions. We have been informed that the Committee on Public Information and sponsor of House Bill number 925, as well as the authors thereof, are in concurrence with the provisions of Senate Bill number 2239. Accordingly, I move that we adopt Senate Bill number 2239 as an amendment to House Bill number 925. So moved, Speaker.
Are there any objection to the motion made? The Chair hears none. The motion is granted.
Speaker, I move that we take up bills on third reading, and particularly I move that we vote on third reading on House Bill number 5616, and that the Secretary General be directed to read only the title of the bill, after which to call the roll nominal voting. So moved.
Without objection, the motion is granted. The Secretary General is directed to call the roll of members for nominal voting on House Bill 5616.
House Bill number 5616.
Mr. Speaker, just a parliamentary inquiry.
We have proceeded with voting, and under the rules, it could not be interrupted.
Let's go ahead first with the voting.
House Bill number 5616, regulating and modernizing the practice of farmers in the Philippines, repealing for the purpose of Public Act number 5921, otherwise known as the Pharmacy Law. Roll call of members. Consideration of House Bill number 5616. Abad, Abaya, Abillanosa, Abu, Abueg, Acidillo, Acharon, Acop, Acosta Alba, Adjong, Advincula, Agarao, Agabao, Aglipay Villar, Agyao, Albano, Alcala, Alejano, Aliping, Almario, Almonte, Alvarez, Amante, Amatong, Andaya, Angara Castillo, Angping, Antonino, Antonio, Apostol, Aragones, Arbison, Arenas, Arnais, Arroyo, Asilo, Achenza, Aumentado, Bagao, Bagaching, Bagilat, Balindong, Banal, Barcelona Reyes, Barsaga, Batawil, Batucabe, Bautista, Bello, Belmonte, Benitez, Bernos, Biason, Bichara, Binay, Biron, Bundok, Bonoan, Bravo, Briones, Bulot Bigtang, Cabilao, Cagas, Calalay, Calixurbiano, Caminero, Cari, Castelo, Castro, Catamco, Cayetano, Celeste, Serafica, Cerilles, Chipeco, Po, Cuanco, Colgantes, Colmenares, Cortuna, Cosalan, Luis González, Cuba, Cueva, Dalog, De Angiran, Daza, De Jesús, De Venecia, Defensor, Del Mar, Del Rosario, De La Cruz, De Los Montalla, De Maporo, Duavit, Durano, Di, Echeverri, Enverga, Erice, Erigel, Ermita Buain, Escudero, Espina, Estrella, Evardone, Fariñas, Fernández, Ferrer, Periol, Flores, Fortun, Fortuno, Fuentebella, Garay, García, García Albano, Garín, Gechelian, Gerón, Gerón Robledo, Go, Gómez, González, Goriceta, Gonlau, Guiau, Gullas, Gurgundo, Gutierrez, Hagedorn, Jaresco, Tamas Alemán, Hernández, Hicap, Hofer, Ilagan, Iway, Alusos, Javier, Cato, Co, Conjun, Labadlabad, Lacson Noel, Lagdameo, Lagman, Lanete, Liachon, Ledesma, Lee, Leonadia, Leonel Pizarro, Labrigat, Loong, López, Loyola, Macapagalaroyo, Macrojo Nuño, Madrona, Magsaysay, Manalo, Magododato, Marcos, Mascariña, Masongsong, Matugas, Miliana, Mendoza, Mercado, Mercado Revilla, Mirasol, Montejo, Nava, Noel, Nograles, Huaminal, Ocampo, Olivares, Ong, Ortega, Pacquiao, Padilla, Paduano, Paez, Pagdilao, Pancho, Panganiban, Pakis, Pernes, Piemonte, Plaza, Ponceril, Pimicis Gabas, Puno, Kimbo, Kisumbing, Redaza, Ramirez Sato, Ramos, Relámpagos, Revilla, Ridón, Rivera, Robes, Rodríguez, Román, Romarate, Romualdez, Romualdo, Romulo, Roque, Sakdalan, Sahali, Sakaluran, Salimbangon, Salvación, Santiago, Sarmiento, Sema, Singson, Swansing, Suárez, Alvarado, Tamutín, Tan, Tejada, Chodoro, Tevez, Chanco, Cheng, Ting, Tino, Tolentino, Treñas, Tugna, Tupas, Turabin, Ataman, Ti Delgado, Umali, Unabia, Ungab, Uy, Vargas, Vargas Alfonso, Vilarde, Velasco, Villanueva, Villar, Villarica, Violago, Yap, Yu, Zamora, Zarate, Subiri.
With 189 members voting in the affirmative, with no negative vote, the chair declares House Bill 5616 approved on third and final reading. Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, I move that we take up on third reading House Bill number 6410 and direct the Secretary General to read title of the bill and call the roll for nominal voting.
Without objection, the motion is granted. The Secretary General is directed to call the roll of members for nominal voting on House Bill number 6410.
House Bill number 6410, an act instituting the Magna Carta of daycare workers. Roll call of members consideration House Bill number 6410. Abad, Abaya, Abilianosa, Abu, Abweg, Asidillo, Acharon, Ako, Pacosta Alba, Adjong, Advincula, Agarao, Agabao, Aglipay Villar, Agiao, Albano, Alcala, Alejano, Aliping, Almario, Almonte, Alvarez, Amante, Amatong, Andaya, Angara Castillo, Angping, Antonino, Antonio, Apostol, Aragones, Arbizon, Arenas, Arraiz, Arroyo, Asilo, Achenza, Aumentado, Bagao, Bagaching, Bagilet, Belindong, Banal, Barcelona, Reyes, Barsaga, Batawil, Batocabe, Bautista, Bello, Belmonte, Benitez, Bernas, Biason, Bichara, Binay, Biron, Bundok, Bunoan, Bravo, Briones, Burutbigtang, Kabilao, Cagas, Calalay, Calixtorubiano, Caminero, Cari, Castelo, Castro, Catanco, Cayetano, Celeste, Serafica, Cerilla, Cipeco, Co, Cuaco, Collantes, Colmenares, Cortuna, Cosalán, Coscusales, Cua, Cueva, Dalog, De Angiran, Daza, De Jesús, De Venecia, Defensor, Del Mar, Del Rosario, De La Cruz, De La Somontalla, De Maporo, Duavit, Durano, Di, Echuberi, Enverga, Erice, Erigel, Ermita, Buayen, Escudero, Espina, Estrella, Bardone, Fariñas, Fernández, Ferrer, Ferriol, Flores, Fortun, Fortuno, Fuentebella, Garay, García, García Albano, Garin, Gachalian, Heron, Heron Robredo, Go, Gomez, Gonzalez, Guriseta, Gullau, Giau, Gullas, Gurigundo, Gutierrez, Sagedor, Neresco, Tamas, Aliman, Hernandez, Hicap, Hofer, Ilagan, Iway, Helosos, Xavier, Cato, Co, Conjun, Labad-Labad, Lacson Noel, Lagdameo, Lagman, Lanete, Liachon, Ledesma, Lee, Leonadia, Leone Pizarro, Lobrigat, Loong, Lopez, Loyola, Macapagalaroyo, Macrojo Nuño, Madrona, Magsesay, Manalo, Magudadato, Marcos, Mascariña, Magzuzong, Matugas, Miliana, Mendoza, Mercado, Mercado Urbillo, Mirasol, Montejo, Nava, Noel, Nograles, Ominal, Ocampo, Olivares, Ong, Ortega, Pacquiao, Padilla, Paduano, Pais, Pagdilao, Pancho, Panganiban, Pakis, Pernes, Piemonte, Plaza, Poncirilo, Pimisio, Sagabas, Puno, Kimbo, Kisumbing, Radasa, Ramiresato, Ramos, Relámpagos, Urbillo, Ridón, Rivera, Robes, Rodríguez, Román, Romarate, Romualdez, Romualdo, Rómulo, Roque, Sagdalan, Sahali, Sacaluran, Salimbango, Salvación, Sanchago, Sarmiento, Sema, Simpson, Suelzín, Suárez, Alvarado, Tambuntín, Tan, Tejada, Chodoro, Tevez, Chanco, Cheng, Ting, Tiño, Talentino, Treñas, Tugna, Tupas, Turabi, Nataman, Titi, Ti Delgado, Umali, Unabia, Ungab, Uy, Vargas, Vargas Alfonso, Vilarde, Velasco, Villanueva, Villar, Villarica, Villago, Yap, Yu, Zamora, Zarate, Subiri.
With 189 members voting in the affirmative, no negative votes registered, House Bill 6410 is approved on third and final reading. Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, I move that we take up on third reading House Bill number 6414, direct the Secretary General to read title of the bill and thereafter call the roll for nominal voting.
Without objection, the motion is granted. The Secretary General is directed to call the roll of members for nominal voting.
House Bill number 6414, an act strengthening further the special program for employment of students, amending for the purpose sections 1, 2, 3, and 5, and repealing section 4 of RA, Republic Act 9547, amending Republic Act 7223, otherwise known as a special program for employment of students. Roll call of members, consideration House Bill number 6414. Abad, Abaya, Villanosa, Abu, Adjong, Advincula, Aglipay, Villar, Agiao, Almonte, Alvarez, Samatong, Andaya, Angping, Antonino, Arnaiz, Arroyo, Asilo, Bagao, Bagaching, Bagilat, Manal, Barcelona, Reyes, Batawil, Batukabi, Bautista, Benitez, Bernas, Bulutbigtang, Kabilao, Cagas, Castro, Catampo, Colmenares, Cotuna, Cosalan, De Jesus, De Venecia, Del Mar, Del Rosario, De La Cruz, Duwabit, Durano, Erice, Erigel, Escudero, Espina, Feriol, Flores, Garay, Garcia, Garin, Gachalian, Heron, Go, Gomez, Gonzalez, Goreseta, Gualao, Gulias, Gunigundo, Jaresco, Atama, Saliman, Hernandez, Hicap, Hopper, Ilagan, Iway, Helusos, Ko, Kungun, Labad-Labad, Lagdameo, Lagman, Lanete, Leonadia, Labrigat, Loong, Macrohonunyo, Madrona, Marcos, Mascarinha, Masungsong, Matugas, Monteo, Nava, Uaminal, Ocampo, Olivares, Padilla, Paduano, Paez, Pagdilao, Plaza, Puno, Kimbo, Kisumbing, Radasa, Ramirez, Ramirezato, Ridon, Rivera, Robes, Romarate, Romualdez, Acoluran, Salimbango, Salvacion, Sarmiento, Singson, Swansing, Suarez, Alvarado, Tebes, Chanco, Tiño, Tolentino, Trellas, Tugna, Tupasti, Ungab, Uy, Vargas, Bilarde, Velasco, Villanueva, Villar, Villarica, Bilago, Yap, Yu, Zamora, Zarate, Subiri.
With 189 votes in the affirmative and no negative vote registered, House Bill number 6414 is approved on third and final reading. Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, I move that we take up on third reading House Bill number 6415, direct the Secretary General to read the title of the bill, and thereafter call the roll for nominal voting.
Without objection, the Secretary General is directed to read, to call the roll of members for nominal voting. So directed.
House Bill number 6415, an act institutionalizing the nationwide implementation of the JobStart Philippines program. Roll call of members. Consideration House Bill number 6415. Abad, Abaya, Villanosa, Agarao, Agabao, Agyao, Albano, Alvarez, Amante, Amatong, Andaya, Angping, Antonino, Atienza, Aumentado, Bagao, Bagaching, Bagilat, Barsaga, Batawil, Batokabe, Bautista, Bello, Biasa, Bichara, Binay, Biron, Bundok, Briones, Cabilao, Cagas, Calalay, Castelo, Castro, Chipeco, Co, Cuaco, Cosalan, Cua, Cueva, Dalog, Defensor, Del Mar, Del Rosario, De La Cruz, Duwabit, Durano, D. Echeverri, Enverga, Erice, Espina, Estrella, Fariñas, Fernandez, Ferriol, Flores, García, Garín, Gachalian, Heron, Go, Gomez, Gonzalez, Guadalau, Guiao, Gullas, Curigundo, Hagedorn, Jaresco, Atama, Salman, Hernandez, Hicap, Hopper, Ilagan, Iway, Conjunt, Calabad-Labad, Ledesma, Lilio, Nardia, Loong, López, Magdesay, Manalo, Mangudadato, Mendoza, Mirasol, Montejo, Nograles, Suaminal, Ocampo, Olivares, Pancho, Pangliban, Pakis, Puno, Kisumbing, Radasa, Ramirez, Sato, Rivera, Robes, Rodriguez, Sumaldo, Romulo, Sarmiento, Sema, Swansing, Suarez, Tambunting, Tan, Chodoro, Tevez, Chanco, Cheng, Ting, Tolentino, Treñas, Tugna, Tupas, Ungab, Uy, Vargas, Bilarde, Velasco, Villanueva, Villarica, Biolago, Yap, Yu, Zamora, Zarate, Subiri.
With 189 votes in the affirmative and no negative vote registered, House Bill number 6415 is approved on third and final reading. Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, I move that we take up on third reading House Bill number 6421. Direct the Secretary General to read the title of the bill and call the roll for nominal voting.
Without objection, the Secretary General is directed to call the roll of members for nominal voting on House Bill 6421.
House Bill number 6421, an act strengthening, modernizing, and aligning the process of agricultural engineering in the country into the internationally recognized practice of agricultural and biosystems engineering. Roll call of members, consideration House Bill number 6421. Abad, Abaya, Villanosa, Abu, Abeg, Asidillo, Agabao, Agyao, Albano, Amante, Amatong, Angping, Antonino, Arnaiz, Arroyo, Asilo, Banal, Barsaga, Batawil, Batukabe, Bautista, Bichara, Binay, Biron, Bundok, Kabilao, Cagas, Castro, Catamco, Cayetano, Siriles, Chipeco, Co, Cueva, Dalog, De Anghirang, De Jesus, Defensor, Del Mar, Del Rosario, De La Cruz, Echeverri, Enverga, Fariñas, Fernandez, Ferrer, Fortun, Fortuno, Garcia, Garin, Gachalian, Heron, Go, Gomez, Gonzalez, Guanlao, Giao, Gullas, Hagedorn, Jaresco, Hernandez, Sikap, Hopper, Ilagan, Iway, Co, Conjun, Labad-Labad, Lagman, Lanete, Lilio, Nardia, Loong, López, Loyola, Madrona, Magsaysay, Mangudadato, Marcos, Mascarinha, Masongsong, Matugas, Mirasol, Montejo, Noel, Nograles, Suaminal, Ocampo, Olivares, Paez, Pagdilao, Pancho, Piamonte, Plaza, Puno, Kimbo, Kisumbing, Radasa, Rivera, Robes, Romarate, Romualdez, Roques, Actalan, Saali, Salvacion, Sanchaco, Sarmiento, Swansing, Suarez, Tan Tejada Chodoro Teves Chanco Cheng Tugna Tupas Umali Unabia Uy Vargas Bilarde Velasco Villanueva Villar Villarica Bilago Yap Yu Zamora Sarate Subiri.
With 189 members voting in the affirmative and no negative vote registered, House Bill number 6421 is approved on third and final reading. Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, I move that we take up on third reading House Bill number 6424, direct the Secretary General to read the title of the bill, and thereafter call the roll for nominal voting.
Without objection, the motion is granted. The Secretary General is directed to call the roll of members for nominal voting on House Bill 6424.
House Bill number 6424, an act instituting policies for the protection and welfare of caregivers in the practice of their profession. Roll call of members, consideration House Bill number 6424, Abad Abaya Villanosa Abu Abweg Agabao Agyao Albano Andaya Abison Arenas Aumentado Bagao Bagaching Barsaga Batawil Batokabe Bautista Bravo Briones Castro Katamco Cortuna Cosalan Dasa de Jesus de Venecia Defensor del Mar del Rosario de la Cruz Enverga Erisa Espina Ebardone Pariñas Fernandez Portun Portuno Pentebella Garay García Garin Gachalian Heron Go Gomez González Guriseta Gumalao Guiao Jaresco Hernandez Sikap Hofer Ilagan Iba Elosos Co Conjun Labadlabad, Lagdameo, Lagman, Lanete, Liachon, Ledesma, López, Loyola, Marcos, Mascariña, Masongsong, Mendoza, Mirasol, Montejo, Umaminal, Ocampo, Olivares, Paduano, Paez, Puno, Kimbo, Kisumbing, Robes, Rodriguez, Sumualdes, Romualdo, Sahari, Sakaluran, Sema, Singson, Swansing, Suarez, Alvarado, Tevez, Chanco, Cheng, Ting, Tupas, Ti, Umali, Unabia, Ungab, Uy, Vargas, Bilardo, Velasco, Villanueva, Villar, Villarica, Biolago, Yap, Yu, Zamora, Sarate, Subiri.
With 189 members voting in the affirmative and no negative vote registered, House Bill number 6424 is approved on third and final reading. Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, I move that we take up on third reading House Bill number 6428, direct the Secretary General to read the title of the bill and thereafter call the roll for nominal voting.
Without objection, the motion is granted. The Secretary General is directed to call the roll of members for nominal voting on House Bill number 6428.
House Bill number 6428, an act declaring Filipino Sign Language as the national sign language of the Filipino deaf and the official language of government in all transactions involving the deaf and mandating its use in all public schools, broadcast media, and workplaces. Roll call of members, consideration House Bill number 6428. Abad Abaya Villanosa Adjong Agarao Agabao Almario Almonte Angping Antonino Arbison Arenas Balindong Banal Barsaga Batawil Batokabe Bautista Bundok Bonoan Kabilao Cagas Katamco Cayetano Cerines Chipeco Cueva Dalog Del Mar Del Rosario De La Cruz Duwabit Norano Escudero Espina Fernandez Ferrer Flores Portun García Garin Gachalian Heron Go Gomez Giao Gullas Curigundo Gutierrez Sagador Jaresco Hernandez, Sikap, Hofer, Ilagan, Iway, Helosos, Labad-Labad, Lagdameo, Lilio, Nadia, Lopez, Loyola, Mascariña, Masongsong, Matugas, Montejo, Nava, Nograles, Olguvaminal, Ocampo, Olivares, Paez, Pagdilao, Pancho, Pakis, Pernes, Puno, Kimbo, Kisumbing, Radasa, Ramirez, Ramirez Sato, Ramos, Relampagos, Rodriguez, Roman, Romarate, Romulo, Roque, Sahali, Sacaluran, Salvacion, Sarmiento, Sema, Singson, Swansing, Suarez, Celbarado, Tejada, Chodoro, Tugna, Tupasti, Ungab, Uy, Vargas, Bilardo, Velasco, Villanueva, Villar, Villarica, Biolago, Yap, Yu, Zamora, Sarate, Subiri.
With 189 members voting in the affirmative and no negative vote registered, House Bill number 6428 is approved on third and final reading. Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, with leave of the House, I move for the omnibus consideration of the following bills on second reading, namely House Bill number 6433, 6439, 6436, 6437, 6438, 6170, 6169, and 6429. Let the explanatory note of the respective bills be adopted as a sponsorship remarks on the measure. To close the period of sponsorship and debate, there being no member who wishes to interpolate, to open the period of amendments, to approve committee amendments, if any, to approve individual amendments submitted to the Committee on Rules, if any, and to close the period of amendments and to approve the aforementioned measures on second reading. So moved, Mr. Speaker.
Are there any objection? The Chair has none. The omnibus motion is granted. Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, the House and the Senate have approved on third reading House Bill number 6423 and Senate Bill number 2581, respectively, which seek to strengthen the continuing professional education program. We have been informed that the Committee on Higher and Technical Education, sponsor of House Bill number 6423, as well as the authors thereof, are in concurrence with the provisions of Senate Bill number 2581. Mr. Speaker, in accordance with the rules, I move that we adopt Senate Bill number 2581 as an amendment to House Bill number 6423.
Any objection to the motion made? The Chair has none. The motion is granted. Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, the House and the Senate have approved on third reading House Bill number 6421 and Senate Bill number 2434, respectively, which seek to strengthen and modernize the practice of agricultural engineering. We have been informed that the Committee on Civil Service and Professional Regulation, sponsor of House Bill number 6421, as well as the authors thereof, are in concurrence with the provisions of Senate Bill number 2434. Mr. Speaker, in accordance with the rules, I move that we adopt Senate Bill number 2434 as an amendment to House Bill number 6421.
Any objection to the motion made? The Chair has none. The motion is granted. Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, I'd like to acknowledge some guests in the gallery.
Go ahead, Your Honor.
We'd like to acknowledge the guests of the Honorable Maricar Zamora of the 1st District of Compostela Valley. And the guests are the Compostela Valley State College Board of Trustees. And the members are the Honorable Jonathan A. Bayogan, Vice Chair, CVSE Board of Trustees, the Honorable Alan M. Calalas, a member of the CVSC Board of Trustees, and Honorable Almaline N. Costello, member of the CVSC Board of Trustees.
Will the guests of the Honorable Maricar Zamora please rise? To the guests of the Honorable Zamora, you are most welcome to the House of Representatives. Majority Leader.
Yes, for a few minutes suspension of session, Mr. Speaker.
Session suspended.
Session resumed, Mr. Majority Floor Leader.
Mr. Speaker, we are in receipt of the Supreme Court en banc entry of judgment in GR number 219603, dated 26 January 2016, declaring Marie Elizabeth T. Delgado the winner for the position of the member of the House of Representatives for the 1st Legislative District of Surigao del Sur in the 13 May 2013 elections. Mr. Speaker, pursuant to the aforementioned entry of judgment, I move that we allow the Honorable Marie Elizabeth T. Delgado of the 1st District of Surigao del Sur to take her oath. So move, Mr. Speaker.
Yes, any objection? Seeing none, same is carried. Now may I call on incoming Congresswoman Mary Elizabeth T. Delgado and her family to please ascend the rostrum for her oath taking.
Wait, parents mo. Honorable Mary Elizabeth T. Delgado, please raise your right hand for the taking of your oath of office.
I.
Your name?
Mary Elizabeth T. Delgado.
Of
Sarah Street, Barangay Bungtod, Tandag City, Surigao del Sur. Having been elected as representative of the 1st District of Surigao del Sur. Hereby solemnly swear.
That I will well and faithfully discharge to the best of my ability.
That I will well and faithfully discharge to the best of my ability.
The duties of my present position.
The duties of my present position.
And of all others I may hereafter hold under the Republic of the Philippines.
And of all others I may hereafter hold under the Republic of the Philippines.
That I will support and defend the Constitution of the Philippines.
That I will support and defend the Constitution of the Philippines.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same.
And that I will obey the laws, legal orders, and decrees.
And that I will obey the laws, legal orders, and decrees.
Promulgated by the duly constituted authorities of the Republic of the Philippines.
Promulgated by the duly constituted authorities of the Republic of the Philippines.
And that I impose this obligation upon myself.
And that I impose this obligation upon myself.
Voluntarily.
Voluntarily.
Without mental reservation.
Without mental reservation.
Or purpose of evasion.
Or purpose of evasion.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Batanes. Naayos, ha? Naayos yung batanes mo, ha?
Session resumed, Mr. Majority Leader.
Mr. Speaker, we are likewise in receipt of a certificate of proclamation issued by the Commission on Elections, dated 22 March 2016, proclaiming Adhikaing Tinataguyod ng Kooperativa, ating co-op as winner in the party-list elections of May 13, 2013, and to entitle its qualified nominee, Mr. Roberto C. Mascarinha, to sit as its representative to the House of Representatives of the Congress of the Philippines and to serve for a term ending 30 June 2016 in accordance with Section 7, Article 6 of the Constitution. Mr. Speaker, pursuant to the aforementioned certificate of proclamation, I move that we allow the Honorable Mr. Roberto C. Mascarinha, representative of Party List Adhikaing Tinataguyod ng Kooperativa, ating co-op, to take his oath in open session. So moved, Speaker.
Yes, a motion having been made. Any objections? Seeing none, same is hereby approved. And Congressman Roberto C. Mascarinha is invited with his family to the rostrum to take his oath of office.
Yep.
Please raise your right hand, Congressman Roberto C. Mascareña, and repeat your oath of office after me. I, your name?
Roberto C. Mascareña.
Of
Marikina City.
Having been elected as
representative at Inco Party List.
Hereby solemnly swear that I will well and faithfully discharge to the best of my ability.
The duties of my present position and all others.
That I may hereafter hold under the Republic of the Philippines. That I will support and defend the Constitution of the Philippines. That I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same. And that I will obey the laws, legal orders, and decrees. Promulgated by the duly constituted authorities of the Republic of the Philippines. And that I impose this obligation upon myself voluntarily. Without mental reservation. Or purpose of evasion. So help me God. Congratulations.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Mr. Speaker, the House and the Senate have approved on third reading House Bill number 6414 and Senate Bill number 3090, respectively, providing for the special program for employment. We have been informed that the Committee on Labor and Employment, sponsor of said House Bill, as well as the authors thereof, are in concurrence with the provision of Senate Bill number 3090. Accordingly, Mr. Speaker, I move that we adopt Senate Bill number 3090 as an amendment to House Bill number 6414. So move, Mr. Speaker. Is there any objection? Seeing none, the motion is approved. Likewise, Mr. Speaker, the House and the Senate have approved on third reading House Bill number 6415 and Senate Bill number 3091, respectively, providing for the JobStart Philippines Act. We have been informed that the Committee on Labor and Employment, sponsor of House Bill number 6415, as well as the authors thereof, are in concurrence with the provisions of Senate Bill number 3091. Accordingly, I move that we adopt Senate Bill number 3091 as an amendment to House Bill number 3091. So, Mr. Speaker.
Yes. Motion. Is there any objection? Seeing none, motion is approved.
Speaker, the distinguished member from the 1st District of Surigao del Sur, the Honorable Mary Elizabeth T. Delgado, would like to rise on a matter of personal and collective privilege. I therefore move for her recognition.
Any motion? Seeing none, Congresswoman Mary Elizabeth T. Delgado is hereby recognized to deliver her speech.
Mr. Speaker, it is my honor to be here with my honorable colleagues in this House of Congress. When I assumed into office barely 2 months ago to replace Philip Pichai as representative of the 1st District of Surigao del Sur, I immediately asked the House Committee on Rules to set a time for my privileged speech, when we convene on May 23, which is today. When the committee asked me what the privilege speech was for, I said I just wanted to address my fellow congressmen in the 16th Congress for the first and last time. Mr. Speaker, a seat in Congress is one worth fighting for. I know this because it took me a lifetime to get here. And it took me more than myself to get my congressional act together. I stand here today before you because I stubbornly believe that our political institutions continue to work, that the Philippine democracy is a work in progress, and that the Philippines is indeed a republic. But equally important, I stand here today because behind the thick walls of Batasan, across the cold halls of Padre Faura, in the very corridors of power in this nation, there stand real men and women whose humanity transcends their self-interest, whose lives are ruled by what is right, whose hearts are a lot bigger than the power they hold. Yes, there are such people, and in small and big ways, they have shared their hearts to my cause. To this day, I am amazed at how I have reached this 16th Congress. My journey to this very podium has spanned at least 12 years since 2004. And if we trace my life in public service, a total of 24 years since 1992. And yet you'll probably be surprised, maybe I began my public service at age 12. After serving Tandag, capital town of the province of Surigao del Sur, as its vice mayor for one term and mayor for 9 years, in 2004, I ran for a congressional seat, but lost. And you know what happened in that election. I settled to private life and continued to transform lives where I can. In 2013, after seeing the initiatives and reforms made by President Aquino, I ran again, this time against Philip Pichai. Pichai won, but I held in my hands two weapons that influence peddling and horse trading will be hard put to beat. I had my God and my law. You see, in the May 2013 elections, I filed a disqualification case against my opponent, Philip Pichai, and in the COMELEC, they sat on it. So after election, I decided to elevate it in the House of Representatives Electoral Tribunal. For a disqualification case that dealt with plainly a question of law, it took the HRET a grueling 2.5 years, or until August 2015, to decide my case with finality. I trusted the Supreme Court, although unwillingly at first, because at that time, I was on the verge of quitting. But my lawyers convinced me to appeal the decision to the final arbiter, even forgoing their legal fees. And for believing in me, I am forever grateful to them. And so, with my faith in God, I appeal the HRET decision to the Supreme Court. In contrast, it took only 5 months for the highest tribunal of the land to rule, and it did so unanimously in my favor. Within the next 1 month, the Supreme Court threw out Pichai's motion for reconsideration, acted with speed, and entered in its books a judgment both final and executory. A testament that the law, pure and unadulterated, remains to be the voice of reason behind the sovereign will of the Filipino people. I played by the book, I won by the book. And my stubborn trust in God, in the law, and our institutions have made that trust worth it and have made my victory a little bit sweeter. And I thank our Honorable Speaker, Sonny Belmonte, for recognizing this unlikely legal victory and for welcoming me as a member of the 16th Congress. For some of you, the journey to a congressional seat is a fast and easy one. No opponents, no threats. But for someone like me who bore the brunt of our democracy's birth pangs, this, I remind you, to every member of Congress belongs the immense opportunity to go beyond self and family, to influence and affect real lives through the law. After all, in me, the law has come full circle. I use the law to get here today and own this privilege of addressing you. In the same way that a congressman serves the fundamental purpose of crafting laws, the rules by which our people could actually achieve the blessings of democracy, justice, equality, and peace. And if my personal experience shows that the law actually works, then the law certainly will for those people who need it even more than I do. In my more than 2 decades in public service, I have met these people. One is Anna, her skin bronzed by a coastal life. Anna is orphaned at age 7 by her fisherman father, who one night failed to come home from the high seas because he disappeared. Or Junjun, the 16-year-old whose parents are both jobless, but who graduated on top of his class at Maitom High School. Junjun was a young man who almost did not go to college because he did not know that someone like him could actually enroll in the Surigao del Sur Polytechnic State College. Perhaps my personal encounters with the likes of Anna and Junjun early in my life have ignited my passion for a government that truly works and for laws that brought real people to the right places. In normal circumstances, I would have worn a simple business suit. But today is an extraordinary day, and I wanted to put emphasis that I am proud of my heritage, proud to be a Filipino, and proud to be a woman. It is a rare privilege for me to show that a political heritage could be harmonized with a clean and honest life in public service. My grandmother was the first lady governor of the then undivided province of Surigao. She was a woman of strength and compassion who raised by herself 7 children after she became widowed early on. One of her sons, my father, former Congressman Mario Cerati, became a member of the 8th, 9th, and 10th Congress. He wrote laws that have benefited the people of Surigao del Sur, like the creation of Caraga Region, the Adela Cerati Medical Center, and the Surigao del Sur Polytechnic State College. With the same vigor, he wrote laws of national significance, like those which promoted summer employment for the youth and those which gave scholarships to students interested in science and technology. My mother, Gloria T., equally personified service for others and devoted her time to God and others before self and even our family. And I thank my parents for the person that I am today, a woman of strength with a deep faith in God. I also wish to thank my children, who are my source of inspiration and my strength. And in spite of my roots, it is a blessing in disguise that I assumed office at a time when I was not running for an elective position, joining the fray like most of you did, because then the irresistible temptation to use my public office for the election would have hovered over me. Without the fear of losing power, I saw clearer. I saw that our people wanted change. I saw that our people wanted government to work for them and appreciated public officials who moved towards that direction. I saw that our people were willing to work hard, but they needed government for something to work on. They want their representatives to hear them out, to listen to their needs, and speak for them. Act like a true representative, in other words. One time, a friend asked me why I could not put my eyes out of a congressional seat, as opposed to a position in the local government. I simply answered that I keep on driving at right now. A congressional office is a platform for real change in governance. By their lawmaking power, congressmen carry the potential force to affect the lives of 100 million Filipinos instead of just a few hundred thousands if I were a governor or a mayor. Mr. Speaker, do not underestimate the power in your hands today, and do not ignore the clamor of our people. Early in my speech, I spoke about real men and women who took the time to help me get this seat, whose positions they could have used to refuse the law from taking command. I did not know that such men and women still existed, but they do. And I make this speech today in their honor. Thank you from the very bottom of my heart. You know who you are, and I give you my heart. My fellow colleagues, be that person. Be the one who decides by what is right, who votes by what the people need, who gets a special thank you from someone as frail, petite, and powerless as I am, when that person achieves the unachievable, because you allow just the law to take the course. When you hear that someone say thank you, I am sure it will make you stand proud, and it will pierce your heart with joy. This is the essence and meaning of life. To those who will be coming back in the next Congress, work together with the incoming administration of President-elect Rodi Aswan to make the Philippines not just the tiger economy of Asia, but a country with an empowered citizenry, where everyone has equal opportunity, where parents have the opportunity to feed and shelter their families, where the people enjoy an efficient public transport system that will shorten commute times, where our overseas Filipino workers have an option to remain in the country, where Christians, Muslims, Lumads, and other ethnic groups live together as brothers and sisters harmoniously as one Filipino, where insurgency is a thing in the past as rebels are encouraged to go back to their families, where economic gains not just benefit a few, but are enjoyed by all. Do not forget our duty to be kind to Mother Nature and to preserve her for future generations. In the light of the threat of global warming and climate change, let us effect policies that would not destroy and wantonly exploit our mineral and natural resources, where harnessing renewable sources of energy become the priority and the mandate. And to those who, like me, will be ending their term on June 30, this should not stop us from doing our part in helping build a nation of one united people. Let us unite in helping those who have less in life have more. Let us make the Bayanihan spirit, of which the Filipinos are known for, be a way of life. After all, when we leave this earth, we cannot take with us our possessions. And what matters is to have lived with meaning, where the joy is in giving and sharing our lives with others. Maraming salamat po sa pagkakataong ito. Mabuhay ang Pilipinas, mabuhay ang bawat Pilipino. God bless us all.
Speaker, I move that we refer the speech of the distinguished lady from the 1st District of Surigao del Sur to the Committee on Rules. So move, Speaker.
Without objection, the motion is granted.
Mr. Speaker, I move for an omnibus motion to elect the Honorable Alan J. Velasco as an additional member to the following committees: Ecology, Justice, Banks and Financial Intermediaries, Information and Communications Technology, National Defense and Security. So move, Speaker.
Without objection, motion is granted.
Speaker, I move that we suspend session to give way to the joint session of Congress. Mr. Speaker, so move.
Without objection, session is suspended.